My name is Kyle Wakefield, and for the past, I guess, 5 or 6 years now, I've been working full-time online, and it kind of started off in college as just a side kind of pet project, something I wanted to research, and after about 30 minutes or 45 minutes of poking around the ClickBank site, I learned just kind of the basics of what affiliate marketing was. It kind of got me my feet wet with just the idea of affiliate marketing specifically. So fast forward about almost a year, I graduated and decided that I was in the process of taking a job with a well-known Fortune 50 company, and was also thinking about my idea I had in college based off of learning about affiliate marketing. And I realized if there was ever a time to do it, it would be then, fresh out of school. And so I got with a web designer. A friend of mine's mom was a web designer, and I kind of told her what I wanted to do. And she helped me with my first project, which was a modest success, but it kind of gave me some time to learn more about affiliate marketing. And within a few months of really doing it full-time out of school, it was my full-time income, and still has been to this day. First thing was, in terms of how did I pick products to promote, I just looked for the most popular ones, because I had this kind of idea from the beginning that I wasn't going to go out and try to reinvent the wheel and, you know, come up with some obscure topic that, you know, I just was sure people were going to be interested in. I wanted to find the top, you know, top niches and yep. go after those, because I realized they were big enough that I could come in and even take a small piece of a much larger pie than a big piece of a small pie. And so I picked just popular proven products on ClickBank to start off with. Because when you do get started, make sure you model the right people and you're not following the people who don't know what they're doing or who can just write a good sales letter and make you think they know what they're doing. I like to have every, you know, a list of all that I need to know it all ahead of time before I do anything. And a lot of times with business, you kind of have to just make your best educated guess after you take in all these inputs and you just act. And the acting, what I found for people, myself included at times, is the hardest part, because you'll get caught up in that paralysis of analysis where you just think you have to know every, you know, angle to every question that might be asked of you. And if you don't know it, well, then you can't do it. And in reality, that's not true. And if you look at a lot of the guys that are successful, not just in, you know, the internet world, but offline and in business and whatnot, I think a lot of times it comes down to they researched, they knew what they were getting into. So it wasn't like they just had dumb luck, but they just acted. You know, once they had all those inputs and they had done their research, they just did it, even though they probably at the time didn't have a full knowledge of what they were getting into. I own a number of websites, and there's one that I very, very seldomly touch anymore. And it doesn't make a lot of money. I mean, it probably makes, well, I mean, it's a fair bit of money. For not touching it, it's good money, about $1,000 a month. Don't even hardly touch it at all. And anybody would look at that and go, great, $1,000 a month. Well, that's fantastic. I'd say there's more and more people that are realizing the value of websites in terms of, you know, digital real estate. You'll hear that term thrown around a lot.
Right.
But it really is, because you've got this website and content that produces traffic and income when you do certain things. And so it becomes a process that when you can go out and, you know, identify a large enough market, which is also what I tell people, don't try to go in and, you know, pick some new niche that you're going to invent and make money with. Find something that people you know are already spending money with, and then go out and find a website that is in that market, and then just do it. Because if they're going to spend, you know, $8 billion next year on health and fitness products, well, why not spend a couple hundred thousand with you? So my biggest thing for people that are getting started would be, don't worry about knowing every piece of the puzzle. Just know a lot of it, and circle yourselves around people or resources that can keep you appraised of what's going on and keep you moving in that direction.